This is going to be the second video about set operations and Venn diagrams. And in this video, what I want to do is deal with set operations involving three different sets. So here's the first example. I've got the intersection of sets A and B. And after I find that intersection, I want to find the intersection of that with set C. So I'm going to draw a rectangle for the universal set. And then I'll draw three circles. A circle for set A. I'll overlap that with a circle for set B. And I'll have another circle that overlaps both of them for set C. The first thing I'm looking for is the part in parentheses, the intersection of sets A and B. Well, the intersection of sets A and B is going to be the place where A and B overlap. So I'm going to shade that in. And now I want the place where that shaded area intersects with set C. Now, if I look at all of set C, the only place where set C intersects with that shaded area is this one little sort of triangle in the middle of the three sets. Okay, erase the part that I'd shaded at first, and what I'm left with is this one place in the middle where the three sets overlap. Okay, let's compare that with something else. Here, once again, I'm starting with the intersection of sets A and B, but then I want to take that and have the union of that with set C. So inside my universal set, I draw three overlapping circles. And the intersection of A and B is still going to be that overlap between A and B. And now I want the union of that overlapping area and set C. So I can circle in, since it's a union, I can shade in all of set C. And now what I've got here is the entire set C, the circle that was C, plus the place where I had an overlap between A and B. Okay, here's the next one. In this one, I've got the union of A and B, and from that, I'm subtracting out, I'm taking away anything that was in set C. So in other words, I'm going to have the relative complement of C in the union of A and B. Okay, so inside my universal set, once again, those three circles, A, B, and C, and the union of A and B means I'm going to shade in everything that's either within circle A or within circle B or in both of them. And now what I want to do is take out the part that's in C. So what I'm going to do is erase or unshade all of the area that's inside circle C. And what I'm left with is basically just anything that's in A as well as anything that's in B for both of them that are not in C. So that was the union of A and B. And then I took away anything that happened to be in C. Okay, a few more. So this one's going to involve the complement. Here I've got a union of A and B, but I'm taking the complement of that union of A and B. And then from that, I'm taking away anything that's in set C. So let's see how that works. You notice in all of these, what I'm doing is starting out inside the parentheses, and then I'll do whatever else I have after that. So my universal set, here's A, B, and C. And the union of A and B would be the area within A, or the area within B, or the area where they overlap. But I want the complement of that. So what I want to do is shade in anything that is not in A and not in B, which means I'm going to go outside the circles. I'm shading in that whole area. I'm also shading in anything in C, which is not in A or B. Okay, so what I've got so far is the complement of A union B. And now from that, I want to take away anything which is in C. So from the shaded area, I'm going to take away which is in C, which basically means I can get the shading out of the C. And now what I've got basically is just all of the area in the universal set, which is not in A, not in B, and not in C, not in any of them. Okay? And here's one more. Here I've got two sets of parentheses. I want the intersection of A and B, and I'm going to have the union of that with the intersection of B and C. So here's what that's going to look like. I have set A, set B, and set C as overlapping circles. I want the intersection of A and B. So that's going to be this area here where A and B overlap each other. And then I want the union of that. So since it's going to be a union of that, I won't have to erase anything. I'm going to want the union of that with set B and C. I'm sorry, the intersection of B and C. So the intersection of B and C is going to be the overlapping area for B and C, which will be this. Okay, so what I've got is every A and B overlap, that was the intersection of A and B, as well as every place where B and C overlap, the intersection of B and C, and since it's the union of those two overlapping areas, it means I'm going to include anything which I've shaded from the first intersection as well as the second intersection. Okay, so that's the basic idea. That's all I'm going to do with this video. I'm going to do one more video at least where we start out with Venn diagrams and work our way back to the notation that would have created it. Okay, so take care. I'll see you next time.